T20 cricket began in 2002 in England, and it was a lot of fun. Hot tubs by the boundary, fancy dress, players with mics on, and an exciting game of cricket in under 3 hours. Fans flocked to the stadium to get their dose of what was then called 2020 cricket. But over 4,000 miles away in India, there was little interest in the format. That all changed, though, one fateful day in 2007. The first ever T20 World Cup final, India versus Pakistan. Misbah-ul Haq looked like he'd sealed the trophy, but then an ill-advised ramp shot was caught on the boundary.
The catch is taken, and India won!
And all of a sudden, India were the world champions of a format that up until then, they hadn't really cared about. Well, boys and girls, they cared about it after that. 1 year later, the Indian Premier League was born. A T20 tournament featuring some of the best players in the world playing alongside Indian domestic talent, all produced beautifully with Bollywood-like production value. It was a smash hit. And with that success came money. Players would take breaks from even representing their own countries to participate in the IPL. And it wasn't just for the big money contracts, although I imagine that was a significant part of the decision. Now, 14 years after its inception, the IPL has just signed a $6 billion rights deal, making it the second most valuable sporting league in the world, only behind the NFL.
Lock in now, laser focus!
That's right, even more than the English Football Premier League. Indian players are getting progressively better, and the exposure to some of the world's premier performers has improved facilities in the country tenfold. In fact, India has so much talent, they sometimes have two men's teams playing at the same time. And to think, it could all have been so different if Misbah-ul Haq had picked a different shot that night in Johannesburg. Well, probably not. I mean, there's a billion people in India. They would have got there eventually, one would think.